Hello everyone. This time we're going to discuss about rational equations and radical equations. I'm Catherine Aymerka from the Department of Mathematics and Statistics. Our learning objectives is for you to learn how to solve rational equations and radical equations. A rational equation or a fractional equation is a type of an equation that involves rational expressions. To solve rational equations, one must eliminate the denominators by multiplying both sides of the equation with the least common denominator called the LCD of the rational expression occurring each side of the equation. What are the steps on how to solve rational equations? First is to check the denominators of the rational expressions involved on each side of the equation and get the least common denominator of these rational expressions. Next would be to multiply the LCD obtained in step one on each side of the equation. Then the third step would be to use the distributive property of multiplication. Then, cancel out common factors and simplify. At this point, the simplified equation obtained in step 4 is clear of fractions, and then solve this simplified equation. Finally, check the values obtained in step 5 by substituting these values to the original equation and see if these numbers make the equation true. We have here the following examples in solving rational equations. We have x over 4 equals 2 plus x minus 3 over 3. Four over x plus 1/2 is equal to 5 over x. 2y over y minus 1 equals 3 plus 3 over y plus 1. Let's solve the first one. That is x over 4 equals 2 plus x minus 3 over 3. So here are the steps. First is to check the denominators of the rational expressions involved on each side of the equation and then get the least common denominator or LCD of these rational expressions. So in this case, the LCD, if you take a look at this one, we have 4 here and we have 3. So 4 times 3, the LCD would be 12. Notice that 2 here has a denominator actually equal to 1. And then multiply the LCD obtained in step 1 on each side of the equation. So in this case, we're going to multiply 12 on both sides of this equation. So we have the following. 12 times the quantity x over 4 equals 2 plus x minus 3 over 3 closed quantity times 12. The next step is to use distributive property of multiplication so that when we multiply 12 with x over 4, we come up now with the following. 12 times x over 4 equals, on the other side, distribute 12, so we have 12 times 2 plus 12 times x minus 3 over 3, and you have this. Then cancel out common factors and simplify. So we have 12 times x over 4, 12 divided by 4 would give us 3. So that's why you have 3x. And then you have 12 times 2 plus 12 times the quantity x minus 3 over 3. So this one will give us 3x, and this 12 times 2 will give us 24. 12 times x minus 3 over 3 will give us there 4 times x minus 3. So at this point, the simplified equation obtained in step 4 is clear of fractions. So solve this simplified equation. So you now have the following. 3x equals 24 plus 4 times the quantity x minus 3. So again, distribute 4 to x minus 3. That's why we have here 4x minus 12. And that is 3x equals 12 plus 4x, because we have 24 minus 12 will give us 12. And then 3x minus 4x, so you clear the other one with the variable x. So you will now have 3x minus 4x equals 12. Then when you combine similar terms, that is minus x, so that's equal to 12. The negative x divided by negative 1 and 12 divided by negative 1 here. So you now have x equals negative 12. So what's the next step? That would be to check the value obtained in step 5 by substituting the number to the original equation and see if this makes the equation true. So in this case, we substitute x equals negative 12 to the original equation. So doing that will give us x here is replaced by negative 12 over 4. So you have negative 3 equals 2 plus negative 12 minus 3 over 3. That should give us 2 plus negative 15 over 3. So meaning to say, you come up with negative 3 equals negative 3, which is actually true. And that means that x equal to negative 12 satisfies the equation. So the solution set, therefore, is negative 12. So we have the second example, 4 over x plus 1 half equals 5 over x. So what's the first step here? We have the following. That is, check the denominators of the rational expressions involved on each side of the equation and get the LCD of these rational expressions. So in this case, you have here 4 over x plus 1 half equals 5 over x. Notice that x should not be equal to 0. So the denominators are 2 and x. Therefore, the LCD is 2x. Then multiply the LCD obtained in step 1 on each side of the equation. So what do we have? We now have multiply 2x with 4 over x plus 1 half. Quantity 4 over x plus 1 half close quantity. That's equal to quantity 5 over x close quantity times 2x. And further, do that. What do we have here? So now use the distributive property of multiplication to get the following answer. That is 2x times 4 over x. It can cancel out x over x. Becomes 1 there. But 2 times 4 would give us the following. 2 times 4 plus, and then this one is 2x times 1 half. We now have 2 over 2, that's 1. You only have x times 1 there, and you have 2 times 5, so that's 5 over x times 2x will give us 2 times 5. Meaning to say, you now have, when you try to solve 2 times 4, that gives us 8, x times 1 is x, 2 times 5 is 10. So x therefore is equal to 10 minus 8, that is x is equal to 2. And then substitute that value to the original equation to verify whether it would make the statement true. So the equation is true indeed. Therefore, x is equal to 2 is the solution to the equation. And meaning to say, the solution set contains the value 2. We have the last example here for the first part. We have 2y over y minus 1 equals 3 plus 3 over y plus 1. So the first step again would be for us to check the denominators of the rational expression involved on each side of the equation and get the least common denominator of these rational expressions. In this case, if we take a look, the values of y cannot be negative 1 and 1. So y should not be equal to negative 1 and 1. And the LCD will now be y minus 1 and y plus 1. So because those are the denominators. So multiply the LCD obtained in step 1 on each side of the equation. And when you do that, you come up with the following. Y minus 1 times y plus 1 times the quantity 2y over y minus 1 equals 3 plus 3 over y plus 1 times the quantity y minus 1, quantity y plus 1. So further, when we solve that one, we now have the following. You have to, again, make use of the distributive property. So have y minus 1 times y plus 1, quantity 2y over y minus 1, 3 times y minus 1, y plus 1, plus y minus 1 times y plus 1, times the quantity 3 over y plus 1. So cancel out common factors and simplify. And when we do that, we now have this one, your y minus 1 and y minus 1 cancels out. So what is left is 2y over y plus 1 on one side of the equation, and on the other side of the equation, we had 3 times y minus 1 times the quantity y plus 1 plus 3 times y minus 1. Okay, so next step would be to use step 4. Is the result in step 4? This is now clear of fractions, so use this result to come up with the following. Use distributive property and simplifying 2y times y plus 1. It will give us 2y squared plus 2y equals 3 times y squared minus 1 because y minus 1 times y plus 1 is y squared minus 1. Then distribute 3 again, so you have 3y minus 3. So solving for that, you have 2y squared plus 2y equals 3y squared minus, you distribute 3 here, so you have minus 3 plus 3y minus 3. And you have 2y squared plus 2y equals 3y squared minus 3 and minus 3 will give us minus 6, so plus 3y. Then you have 0 equals 3y squared plus 3y minus 6. Okay, this one, 3y plus 3y minus 6. Then you have minus 2y squared minus 2y. So subtract 2y squared plus 2y on both sides. Then you have 0 equals 3y squared minus 2y squared will give us y squared. 3y minus 2y will give us y. So we have minus 6 there. And then factor if it's factorable. In this case, the factors are y plus 3 times the quantity y minus 2, which is equal to 0. They mean to say y equals negative 3 or y is equal to 2. And then verify whether it will satisfy the equation. Check the value obtained in step 5 by substituting the number to the original equation and see if this makes the equation true. So we have 2y over y minus 1 equals 3 plus 3 over y plus 1. So verify the values when y equals negative 3 and y equals 2. So you satisfy the equation. And when we do that, notice that you will have there 3 over 2 is equal to 3 over 2, which is true. You can check this out later. Then we have here, when y is equal to 2, again, substitute to the original equation, you come up with 4 equals 4, which is true. Meaning to say, the solution set is the set containing negative 3 and now, a radical equation is a type of an equation which has a radical expression on either side of the equation. An extraneous roots are numbers which you can get after solving a transform equation from an original equation. and solving radical equations may result to extraneous roots. As such, one needs to check the values obtained by substituting it to the original equation. So let us now solve equations containing radicals. The first step is to isolate the radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. Then check the index of the radical. Then raise both sides of the equation to a power equal to the index of the radical. Next, perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. Then solve the equation obtained in step 3. And then verify values obtained in step 4 by substituting the number to the original equation. So there are 5 steps here involved. Let's try to solve equations containing radicals. So the first example would be the square root of 4x plus 5 equals x. Second one is to solve x plus square root of x equals 12. And the last one here is to solve the fourth root of 3x plus 4 plus 5 equals 1. Let's try the steps. So in solving square root of 4x plus 5 equals x, we have the following steps. Isolate the radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. Notice that this is already, the radical is already isolated on the first example. So it's already taken care of. Then check the index of the radical. So what's the index? The index here is 2. It says here, raise both sides of the equation to a power equal to the index of the radical. So in this case, we have to raise it to the power 2. And to say we square both sides. We now have square root of 4x plus 5 raised to the second power equals x raised to the second power. Perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. So we raise square root of 4x plus 5 to the second power, which will result into 4x plus 5. We raise x to the second power, so we have x squared. 0 is therefore equal to x squared minus 4x minus 5. If we subtract 4x and add 5 on the other side, that's why we get a 0 here. So you come up now with x squared minus 4x minus 5 is equal to 0. Next would be to solve the equation obtained in step 3. So that when we solve this, we can make use of factoring. Factor x squared minus 4x minus 5. Equal to 0. So when we do that, we come up with x minus 5 times the quantity x plus 1 equal to 0. So we need to say x equal to 5 or x equal to negative 1. The last step would be to check or to verify whether it satisfies the original equation. So we substitute x equal to 5 to the original equation. We come up with square root of 4. Times 5 plus 5 equal to 5, so that's 20, square root of 20 plus 5, but that is square root of 25. So 5 is equal to 5 is true. On the other hand, when we substitute x equal to negative 1, we come up with square root of 4 times the quantity minus 1 plus 5 equals negative 1. But that is negative 4 plus 5. So when you take the square root, it's square root of 1. But on the other side, you have negative 1. This is false. So meaning to say the only solution is x is equal to 5. Remember that extraneous roots are numbers which you can get after solving a transformed equation from an original equation. So here, the solution x equal to negative 1 is actually an extraneous root. So we always need to check the values obtained by substituting it to the original equation so that we get the correct solution set. So the solution set is simply the set containing 5. So x is equal to 5. So another example, x plus square root of x equal to 12. This time, we have to isolate the term which has a radical sign. This one. So we now have x plus square root of x equal to 12. So we isolate square root of x on the left side. We now have x equals 12 minus x on the right side. Next would be to check the index of the radical, then raise both sides of the equation to a power equal to the index of the radical. So in this case, the index is 2. So you raise both sides by 2, come up with square root of x squared plus 12 minus x, the quantity squared. Then we now try to perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. So in this case, we have square root of x and then square root 12 minus x. We come up with x equals 144 minus 24x plus x squared. We just get this. Okay, so that you can point out everything. From here, 144 minus 24x plus x squared is actually from your special product formula here. So 12 minus x, the quantity squared. If you remember, the special product formula says the quantity u minus v squared equals u squared minus 2 times uv plus v squared. That's why you have this one. So 0 now is equal to 144 minus 24x plus x squared minus x. That gives us, we have minus 24x minus x will give us minus 25x plus x squared. X squared minus 25x plus 144 is equal to 0. This result we can actually now try to factor this one out. Let's see. It's not moving if I have the... Okay, so let's just have this one. So solve the equation obtained in step 3. How do we do that? Let me just again, it doesn't work if I have the pointer, so let's remove the pointer again. Come up with the following, x squared minus 25x plus 144 is equal to 0. So factor this out. When you factor x squared minus 25x plus 144, come up with x minus 9 times the quantity x minus 16 is equal to 0. So we have x minus 9 equal to 0 or x minus 16 equal to 0. I mean to say x equal to 9 or x equal to 16. So we still have to verify whether this will satisfy the equation. So for the next step, again, let me remove the pointer. We have the following verified values obtained in step 4 by substituting the number to the original equation. So when x equal to 9, we have the following. That is x plus square root of x equal to 12. X plus square root of 9 is equal to 12. Meaning to say, you have 9 plus what is the square root of 9? That's 3. You have 12 equal to 12. So it's true. On the other hand, when x equal to 16, you will have x plus square root of x equals 12. So substitute x here by 16, x here by 16, come up with 16 plus, the square root of 16 is 4. So you actually have 20 equals 12, which is false. Meaning to say, x equal to 9 is the only element of the solution set, and x equal to 16 is actually not a solution. So that we have the following. Yes, the solution set is simply the set containing 9. Now, in solving equations containing radicals, we have the last example here, which is the fourth root of 3x plus 4 plus 5 is equal to 1. So again, for the steps, we have to isolate the radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. So the given equation is the 4th root of 3x plus 4 plus 5 equals 1. Isolate the radical, the 4th root of 3x plus 4, and get the following. We will have 1 minus 5 on the other side. So we have the 4th root of 3x plus 4 equals negative 4. And then check the index of the radical. The index is actually equal to 4, and then raise both sides of the equation to a power equal to the index of the radical. So meaning to say, from here, what we have here, we now have the following. So the index is 4, raising them, the both sides of the equation by 4, come up the 4th root of 3x plus 4 equals negative 4 raised to the 4. So the next step is to perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. So when we do that, we now have the following. 3x plus 4, the 4th root, and then when you raise it to the power 4, you come up with 3x plus 4, negative 4 raised to the power 4, you have 256. So 3x therefore equals 256 minus 4. 3x is equal to 252. So the next step would be for us to solve the equation obtained in step 3. That means to say we divide both sides here by 3 to come up with the following. That is 3x divided by 3, 252 divided by 3 will give us x equal to 84. So verify the values obtained in step 4 by substituting the number to the original equation. So in x equal to 4, we have the following value. That is the 4th root of 3x plus 4 plus 5 equals 1. Let's see, when you substitute x equal to 84, what's the result? 3 times 84 plus 4. When you take the 4th root, it becomes a 4th root of 256. Plus 5 equals 1. Now we have 4 plus 5 is equal to 1. So I mean to say 9 is actually not equal to 1. That means result is false. Because of that, we say that no value satisfies the equation. Then the solution set is actually equal to your empty set. So here are the steps in solving equations containing two radicals of index 2. First step is to isolate one radical on one side of the equation and move all other terms to the other side of the equation. Next step is to square both sides of the resulting equation in step 1. And then perform the required operation to get a simplified equation. And at this point, there should be one radical of index 2. So isolate the remaining radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. And then again, square both sides of the equation. Next would be to perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. Then solve the equation obtained in step 6. Then verify the values obtained in step 7 by substituting the number of the original equation. So let's solve some example. We have the following: square root of y plus 4 equals square root of 3y plus 2. The second one here is square root of 3x plus 4 minus the square root of 2x minus 4 equals 2. Here are the solutions for number 1 and number 2. So for number 1 first, for letter A, we have the square root of y plus 4 equals 3y plus 2. It's already isolated here. One radical is already isolated. So you can just simply try to find out the index. The index is 2. So what do we do now? We can raise both sides by 2. Come up with following, that is square root of y plus 4 raised to the second power equals square root of 3y plus 2 quantity raised to the second power. So what's the next step? Perform the required operation to get a simplified equation. At this point, there should only be one radical of index 2. So here we have square root of y plus 4 raised to the second power equals square root of 3y plus 2 quantity raised to the second power. So y plus 4 equals square root of 3y, the quantity squared. Okay. Again, we make use of the special product formula here to solve for this quantity, square root of 3y plus 2 quantity squared. Plus, we have 4 square root of 3y plus 4 here. Y plus 4 equals, when you square this, you come up with 3y plus 4 times square root of 3y plus 4. So isolate the remaining radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. So in this case, we now have your y plus 4 equals 3y plus 4 square root of 3y plus 4. So we isolate 4 square root of 3y on one side. You now have y plus 4 minus 3y minus 4 here. So then combine similar terms. Y minus 3y will give us minus 2y. 4 minus 4 will give us actually equal to 0. So the result here is minus 2y equals 4 square root of 3y. Then again, square both sides of the equation. We come up with the following: minus 2y the quantity squared equals 4 square root of 3y the quantity squared. So when we do that, when you square this, it becomes equal to 4y, and this becomes 16 times 3y. Okay, you have this. This 4y squared is equal now to 48y. So solve the equation obtained in step 6, that we now have 4y squared equals 48y, 4y squared minus 48y equals 0, and then factor out 4y, so you have 4y, y minus 12 equal to 0. 4y is equal to 0, or this time, y minus 12 equal to 0. Divide 4y by 4 and 0 by 4. Come up with y equal to 0. Or this one, subtract on both sides of y minus 12 equal to 0 by 12. So you come up with y equal to positive. I'm sorry, not subtract. Add 12 here. So you have y is equal to 12. The result is y equal to 0 or y equals 12. But we still have to verify whether these two will satisfy the original equation. And to do that, we have to substitute again. So when we substitute, we have the following. That is, when y is equal to 0, we have square root of y plus 4 equals 3y plus 2. So substitute y equal to 0. So you have the square root of 0 plus 4 equals 3 times 0 plus 2. And then square root of 4 is equal to 2. This one will give us 0. So you have 0 plus 2. 2 is equal to 2 is actually true. But when y is equal to 12, notice that the result is false. So meaning to say, the solution set would simply be the set containing 0. And then we have square root of 3x plus 4 minus square root of 2x minus 4 equals 2. Let's solve that. So for the steps, we have the following. The first step would be to isolate one radical on one side of the equation. Since there are actually two radicals there, then we have to isolate one on one side. So how do we do that? We have to rewrite it as such. That is, 3x square root of 3x plus 4 is now equal to 2, and then you have square root of 2x minus 4. Then square both sides of the resulting equation in step 1, because that's the index that we found there. We now have square root of 3x plus 4 equals the quantity 2 plus square root of 2x minus 4 quantity squared. Next would be to perform the required operation to get a simplified equation. So at this point, there should only be one radical of index 2. Take a look at this. Try to square root of 3x plus 4, the quantity squared. When you square that, you come up with 3x plus 4. Again, we make use of the special product formula to solve for the quantity 2 plus square root of 2x minus 4 raised to the second power. Use this special product formula and come up now with 4 plus 4 times the square root of 2x minus 4 plus square root of 2x minus 4 the quantity squared. So that 3x now plus 4 equals 4 plus, you now have when you square this, it comes to be 2x minus 4. So 4 plus square root of 2x minus 4 plus 2x minus 4. Meaning to say, you can have here 4 minus 4 is equal to 0 here. We only have 4 plus 4 times square root of 2x minus 4 plus 2x. So the next step is to isolate the remaining radical by moving all other terms to the other side of the equation. So isolate again this one here. This isolate 4 square root of 2x minus 4. So you add both sides by minus 2x. So you have 3x plus 4 minus 2x. You come up with 4 square root of 2x minus 4. So x plus 4 equals 4 square root of 2x minus 4. Then again, square both sides of the equation. So you have this. This one is x plus 4 the quantity squared equals 4 times square root of 2x minus 4 raised to the second power. Then perform the required operation to remove the radical sign and get a simplified equation. So we have the following here. X plus 4 the quantity squared, when you raise that, that's x squared plus 8x plus 16. And when you raise this to the second power, you come up with 16 times the quantity 2x minus 4. So solving for this, we come up with x squared minus 24x plus 80 is equal to 0. What do we do next? We have to factor if it's factorable. If it's not, then you make use of your quadratic formula. In this case, it is factorable, so come up with factors as x minus 4, x minus 20 is equal to 0. So x therefore equal to 4, x equal to 20. Again, we have to verify whether this will be solution set. So if that is the case, then we can say that it's actually a solution. Otherwise, you have to consider only the value which will give us true. In this case, x equal to 4 and x equal to 20 will actually satisfy. X equal to 4 and x equal to 20 will satisfy. Equations involving radicals are actually solved by squaring or by raising both sides of the equation to a power equal to the index of the radical. Observe that the procedure in the above statement, so in this statement, introduces an extra root as shown in example 1a and 1b and 2a above. So we have that one earlier. And this irregularity is justified in remark 1 given below. That is, the remark, if x equal to a, then x squared equals a squared. But if x squared is equal to a squared, then x equal to a or x equal to minus a. Hence, negative a is an extraneous root of the equation x equal to a. Second remark states that for equations involving radicals, it is absolutely necessary that we check for our answers. Because as we had stated earlier, it might be the case that there are some extraneous roots. Or, in some cases, it's actually not a solution and we don't actually have a solution set. So one useful strategy in solving equations with radicals is to isolate a radical on one side of the equation before raising it to a suitable power. So that's what we usually do in solving radicals, equations involving radicals. So we have some exercises here that is for you to solve. I'll leave this one for you to solve later. For our references, we have College Algebra Essentials, 5th edition, 1st one, Algebra and Trigonometry of the Department of Mathematics and Statistics.